Hello guys, in continuing with some basic terms, the important term is that coordination polyhedron. Coordination polyhedron, as you are watching, I have given you in the written. You please revise these terms. This has been asked in exams, number of exams. The spatial arrangement of ligands, spatial means arrangement of atom in space. Spatial arrangement of ligands, atoms which are directly attached to the central atom or ion, is called coordination polyhedron. Some common coordination polyhedron are octahedral, square planar, and tetrahedral. In octahedral, you can give the example CONH3 6 plus 3. Square planar, you can give you NiCO4. In this chapter, you also would like to get the square planar DSP2 hybridization, how we are making. I will explain you. And tetrahedral, you know very well, that is the PTCl4 negative 2. Tetrahedral, that is SP3. And square planar, that is what, the DSP2. DSP2 you learn this in this chapter. I hope so that you have learned in the chemical bonding in the 11th. It is good, otherwise I will explain in this chapter. So shapes you will draw with your cell phone. Shapes of different coordination polyhedron. M represent the central atom and L represent the unit and ligand. If I'll draw the shapes, otherwise no need, you can draw with your cell phone. Then next one, important and easy. It has been asked in exam also. Homoleptic complex and heteroleptic complex. Homoleptic and heteroleptic. In a homoleptic complex, only one type of ligand are present. I can give you example CuCN4 negative 3, and we have taken earlier in the example, first example which we taken, CuNH3 4 plus 2, we have earlier taken. So monodentate, only one type of ligand that represent the homo, same. Then come in the hetero, there are two ligands are known. You can take this one, CO NH3 4 and Cl2. Here you are watching, we are representing the two ligands, ammonia and chlorine. So it is heteroleptic, and it has been also asked in the exams. Then come with me now. Next we will do the nomenclature, primary valency and secondary valency, then VBT, CFT, and then isomerism of this chapter. Now the next is that nomenclature. How we will do the nomenclature? Some names and their some rules I am just going to share you. Please be with me. One more thing which I left, that is oxidation number. That is also important. When you putting the name, then it is coming. In CuCN4-3, you have seen that I have to find out the oxidation number of the copper, central metal atom. It is represented by X. Cyanide are how many? 4. Cyanide charge is minus 1 and equal to minus 3. Then X is equal to coming plus 1. This will be given in the Roman number when we put the name. Second example which I have taken, K3FeCN6. Then potassium are 3, its valency is plus 1. Iron we have to find out, so putting X. Cyanide are 6, its charge is minus 1. Equal to, on the bracket no charge, so it is coming equal to 0. And finally when I solve it, that I am getting X is equal to plus 3. So this will be given in the Roman when we put the name. In the next class, if you would like to share you some names, share the rules also, and how I am just going to tell how to put the name. Goodbye, next class is of the nomenclature.